Alright, let's do it one last time. My name is Marlon, and for the last 13 days, I've been learning Blender. Blender has been in my to-do list for a while, and to be fair, it's been used across different industries so far. Like the last Spider-Verse movie, or one of my favorites, I Lost My Body. On the last BlenderCon, I found out that the last Spider-Verse movie was using Blender to create some special effects. I was especially moved by the story from the 15-year-old boy called Preston Mutanga, and how he started using Blender by the time he was 7-year-old and ended up working on the last Spider-Verse movie. But I think all of us, we always start with the same question.
I don't know how to start.
You? Me?
How do I move? What is that? Yes. I thought it was a camera.
Let me try to make a search.
Today's video will start with modeling the bedroom, then lighting, adding materials, and finally, how to make the scene look better. I tried to make...
From all the tutorials that I found online, Blender Guru has probably one of the best initiations in Blender. The Donut Introduction course is pretty much nowadays an industry standard, so I decided to go through it and make my own jammy donut. Going this way was very helpful as my first days in Blender. But at this stage I knew how to create a donut, but I didn't know how to carry on. So I decided to go my own path.
I'ma do my own thing.
But before getting here, first I needed a plan. So the major goal is create a character that uses a very similar cell shading, the one that is using Cell the Breath of Fire. But something I knew is that I wanted to create this character faster. So as you know, I already know how to model a donut. It will take me weeks to create a full character. The plan? Grab a model that I already made and prepare it for Blender. So let's jump into Blender. At this stage, I already know how to navigate in Blender. I got familiar with all the shortcuts, I know how to apply lights, play with cameras, apply shader, and so on. But the most important thing that I wanted to learn is how to create Toon Shading in Blender. And now, I didn't want to use a pre-made Toon Shader, I wanted to create it myself, so I'm able to experience the software deeper. And this was a great decision, because I was able to skip something that I already knew how to do, and focus on the main goal, get that first character done. Regarding the shader, the most important aspect is this node group that I created, where I'm breaking up the shader, depending on how the light and the volumes are facing the camera. By pressing tab on my keyboard, I could jump into the node group, and this way I managed to keep things clean and simple. The main trick to create the Toon Shader in Blender is the node called Shader to RGB, which is amazing. This node will transform the information from the principal BSDF material into a more cartoon style. But just to warn you, just by default, it's not looking as good as you want. The way my shader works is that I divided every light source into different ramps. In this case, for the main light, the field light, and also the backlight. Since I'm working something with a cartoon style, it was clear to me that these ramps should use a constant interpolation, so the color contrast is more obvious, and it gives more of a toon look. At the end of the shading network, I added different blend nodes. I set them up on different blending modes to get the results that I wanted. Here, there is no right or wrong, since I'm sure you can achieve same or even better results just with a different combination. Back one level up on the shader, I added an extra step to tweak the albedo information by using a hue and a saturation node. This node will help me to tweak the color on the shader, so I didn't need to jump back into Painter and re-export all the textures. I found out that the best way to recreate the specularity on the cell shader by creating a glossy BSDF shader. After that, same as the main node group, I will blend them together before it fits into the final output. I tried to apply same idea on the skin shader, but it didn't really work well. So I ended up creating a roughness texture and plugging it straight on the shader. The hair was something way more complicated, but I think the logic that I applied is something that perhaps you are interested in knowing. First, to make this work, I needed to be sure that the hair had UVs, and they were set up vertically. Once on the shader, I created a noise node and stretched it on the vertical axis. By playing with the scale and the distortion, I could fake an isotropic reflection, somewhat. I also decided to add an extra parameter, so I could increase or decrease the amount of lines on the reflection. I'm going to be honest with you, creating a hair tune shader was more complicated than I thought.
No, maybe your computer's not working.
And even after trying for 2 full days, I don't think I quite succeeded on it. Nevertheless, it got me into a point where I think I was okay, and you know, I can call it done. First, First, you need to make sure that your model is merged in one single mesh. This way, the grease pencil will apply better. Select the mesh and go to Add Grease Pencil and select Object Line Art. This way, it will be applied. Now, you need to hide the merged mesh. So go under Object Properties and change the mesh viewport display to Bounce. This way, only the grease pencil will show up. On the grease pencil properties, I recommend you to lower the thickness to a value of 1 or 2, so it feels more natural. Now you can add multiple strokes modifier. Here you establish how many stroke levels you want to have. I found out that something between 2 or 3 works fine. Also, I would really recommend you to turn paint and play with the center value. This way, you are going to establish which strokes are going to be more visible. Another cool modifier is the Simply modifier. I think this one is quite self-explanatory. Pretty much, it's just going to simplify the lines depending on the factor and the mode you choose. At the end, you choose your style. Blender has been a great tool for me, and definitely I'm going to be creating more characters in the future.